We are into Photoshop and we are going to be creating this box mockup in Adobe Photoshop. So let's just start straight. I downloaded this box on Google. You can get any box you want to use, or you can create it manually. So we need to put the logo as you have seen here and here, then on top the word here. But if we do it manually, it will not be perfectly placed onto the box because the box is in perspective. So our first step is to make one shape. Is to make one shape like this, which is almost this size of the box. And then let's drag it here and try to copy the color, this color of the box. We go to this tool, which is the eyedropper tool, and then copy this color here. So this color will go into this color palette. And when we go back to shape and open its option here, the color will be the first color here. So when we make it sample, it will turn into almost this same color. So since we cannot see it, we have to create a stroke so that we align it very well with this size. So the first step is to convert it into a smart object. Right click, then convert to smart object. Then after, you can go here and add a stroke. This stroke is just for, it's just like a guideline. Later we remove it. So we try to align this shape with the box side. So we zoom in, then we place control on the keyboard, which will turn the cursor into white when we come to an edge. When I go further from an edge, it turns black, and when I come to an edge, it turns white. So I drag this edge onto the edge. So when I drag that edge, it means I'll be only editing this vertex or this point. So I'll also place control and then move this one to this point or this vertex. Then I do the same thing to other side. So please subscribe to my channel, share, like and comment, and please don't forget to hit the bell button so that you get a notification whenever I post a new video. So we try to align it very well to this side. Okay, we name this, let's call it big side. It is always advisable to name your layers. It will make your workflow easy. So after, we can clear the layer style, and so the stroke is now gone. So we also make this side. Still we go create a shape. Create a shape which is almost like this side. Okay, again, sample the color, go to place eye, or go to this tool and then sample this color, then click on our shape and then go to its properties, and the last color will be the last sample you have made. So again, convert it into a smart object, give it a stroke, and then align it to the side you want. Same as we did for the first one, hold control, then move the point to the original box point, and also move this point or that's to this point so that it's well aligned with the original box. Then after right click, then clear layer style. So we are remaining with the top one. Still we will use the same procedure, layer, draw a layer which is almost the same size, take the sample by pressing I on the keyboard or go straight to this and then go straight to this and then sample, which will create a color palette here. And still right click and convert to smart object. You can give it a stroke. So as I said, it is necessary to name all your layers because it will give you a very quick workflow. So the next thing is to duplicate our box. Drag it into here or place Ctrl J on the keyboard, then move it from to the front. You can come here and change to the blending mode you feel like. So here it's a little bit good, but we will see as we continue. Then lock this layer. So we need to place our design into here. So you are going to use the red T logo onto. We'll place it onto our box. So what we are going to do, we are going to double click on this icon for smart object. Tap tap. When you double click on it, it will open in another page. So we will go to our red T logo and drag it into this page, and after we save and go back to our main page, already the red T logo is on our box. So a smart object works as a link between the main artwork and its parts, because we made it in parts. So it has now created a layer which we can edit, and then when we save, the changes come direct to the main artwork. So also for the second one, we are going to do the same thing. Double click, then come here and place our red T logo. Since it is a little bit small, the other side we can also make small, and then save. The same come to this side. So we are now remaining with the top one, and for the top one we are going to use only the word red T. So we'll come here, then cut the word red T, copy it, then come here and paste it That's all. When we save, it will also come here again. So if you want to place it on also the other one, we will do the same procedure. We will copy this text into this one, and boom, when we save, it will also come to this side. So we have already finished to create a mockup, and this mockup is already now a template. So please, when you get any challenge as you are doing, please comment. I'll tell you what to do, or if you are stuck, I'll also drop my WhatsApp number so that I can help you. Let's grow together. And if you have any challenge in these two softwares, Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator, you can please send me a message so that I make a tutorial solving your challenge. And your challenge is a challenge to so many others. So, on continuing on the same thing, let's compose it. So, let's make the background a little bit darker, create a new layer, then send it to back, and then control backspace, and let's try to compose this layer. So we will have to create a shadow, and we'll have to create a shadow of our box. There are so many ways, but let me use this manual one. Let's say the light is hitting from here, so the shadow will come this side. I can just do like this, just a simple one. Further, let's give it 2, then copy this color, but make it more darker, then create a new layer. Control backspace to this side, then send it to back. To remove that white background, you can remove the main box and we remain with this box and this box. Remember, this one is in overlay. So that's the way you can make this compositing. But you can go further into gradients and make it more attractive according to your desire. You can make it more attractive according to your desire. Then you can start your designing as you want. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel, share and like, and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you get a notification whenever I post a new video. I'm Sebu Gaudens for Arena.